Hey everyone, welcome to another video. This video is gonna be my top 3 in every category. This has been a video that has been going around. I'm not sure who started it, but if I find it, I will definitely link it down below. And I will also link down below a few videos that inspired me to do this video. And I'm really excited to show you my favorite products. Let's get right into it. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love trying out new makeup, I love trying out new things, but I also try to not buy too much, focus on the things that I already own. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and I would love to see you again on my channel. So I've seen so many people do this tag and today I'm finally filming it myself. I am changing it up a little bit though, because there are just some categories where I don't feel like I have a top 3 because I don't really use it. Maybe I have only 1 or 2. So these are the categories that I felt were relevant for me, to me, for this video. So it's gonna be mainly like colored cosmetics. If you know me, then you know that I don't really wear foundation, powder, and things like concealer. So this is just gonna be all the fun stuff, all the things I love. So yeah, let's get started. I'm gonna start out with the bronzers. By the way, I'm gonna try to keep this a bit short, but I talk too much. I talk way too much when I do these types of videos. I just wanna give everything the full review. So I'm gonna try to keep it a little bit short, but all these products, like basically all these products, I have other videos about them where I talk about them more in depth, but because I have so much in front of me, I just wanna keep it short and I definitely hope I'm gonna succeed. But let's start with the bronzers. First up in my top 3 bronzers is the Nabla Skin Bronzing in the shade Amber. Beautiful baked gelée formula. It's a beautiful kind of neutral shade, not too pigmented but buildable. It has this beautiful kind of glass skin glowy finish on the cheeks without having any shimmer in it. This looks so beautiful and natural. I really love this one. Next up, we have a bit of a newer favorite. This is a Sol Body Face and Body Bronzing Balm. This is such a good cream bronzer. I use this so much. I use this all the time. I usually use this as like a base under another bronzer and I feel like that looks so beautiful and natural and creamy on the skin. I love how that looks. It's a little bit on the warm side, but I still keep reaching for this one. I still keep grabbing for this one. It's so easy to use, so easy to blend, and it smells really nice. It's just a really effortless product to use. I use this so often. It's a fave that kind of crept up on me. All of a sudden I was using it all the time and there hasn't been another cream bronzer that has topped this for me. It's just so good. And the next thing is an oldie but a goodie. An older favorite in my collection is this. For a second there I forgot what it was called. It's a Kelly Contour Palette by Smashbox. This I've been using for years. It's so good. We have more of a neutral bronzer and more of a contour shade that I sometimes kind of mix, but also sometimes go to this one alone. Beautifully pigmented, a bit more pigmented definitely than that Nabla one, but I really love how easy this is to use and blend out once again. It just gives a beautiful bronze look. It gives a bit more of an impact, but it's still really easy to use. I really think this is a great palette and I would still recommend it. I've been using this for years and years and years, and for a while there, this was the only product I used for bronzing and I was very happy with that. All right, let's move on to the highlighters. First up, I have the Nabla Skin Glazing Highlighter in Privilege. This is my favorite highlighter in my collection. It's so good. It's like this glass skin look. It already says it in the name. There's no shimmer in this. It just looks really glowy. And because of this baked gelée formula, it kind of looks like it's part of your skin. It just really blends in and makes your skin look so good and healthy. It's glowy enough, but in a really natural, flattering way. It also has a beautiful color to it. It kind of has that rosy, peachy pink undertone. But it's still champagne, so it it looks good with so many looks. This is a product where you kind of have to get past that first layer and then it's really easy to pick up. Sometimes I hear people say that they think it's a bit too subtle, but really just go into it a little bit, kind of go past that first layer, and then it's really easy to pick up and really like a beautiful glowing highlighter. It's not extremely subtle, but it's also not extremely metallic and glowy. This is just a perfect formula. I can't get enough of this. This is in my project pen and I keep using this like every day. Yeah, this is so, so good. The next thing is a newer product. This is the Kiko Fruit Explosion Highlighter in Coral Sunset. This is a beautiful kind of deeper highlighter. It's a bit on the bronzy, rose gold, peachy side almost. This looks so creamy on the skin and also so glowy and kind of not metallic, but it has a blindingness to it. It kind of makes your skin look wet. I love this color and this formula is really, really beautiful. Kiko does highlighters so, so well. And that's also why the next highlighter in my top three is this Kiko highlighter. This is the Ocean Feel highlighter in Virtuous Golden Rose. No longer available, but if you just check out their limited editions that they have multiple times a year, they always have baked highlighters, and very often they have a shade like this. It's a beautiful kind of cool toned rose gold shade that on the cheeks also has a golden sheen to it, so it looks good with both cool looks but also with warm looks. Every time I wear this, I just love it. It is so glowy. It is so it's so extremely glowy, but in such a flattering way. It's not metallic. It just really blends into the skin. There's no shimmer in this. It's very smooth and it just makes your skin look so good. And I love this shade. I love highlighters that are just slightly deeper, that are not like extremely light and blinding, but that have just more of a tint that is similar in tone to my skin tone. That's what I really love, but then a beautiful undertone and a beautiful glow. So this one definitely isn't like extremely light on my skin tone. It's kind of like the same depth, and that's just something I really like. And yeah, that's just what works for me. So let's move on to the blushes. So I don't only love glowy cheeks when it comes to the highlighters. I also really, really love glowy blushes. Glowy blushes are my thing, especially this year. I've really, really been getting into that. So that's kind of what I have here in front of me. But none of these are really like glittery. That's not something I'm into. So the first of my top three is the Alva Blusher, the Flower Blusher in Water Lily by Odin's Eye. This blush is so good. It's from their kind of like shimmery, shiny line, but it's not extremely shiny. It's more of a satin, slightly sheeny finish. But this particular color, it's like kind of like a terracotta color, but it has enough mauviness to it that it doesn't look orange, that it doesn't look too much. It just makes me look very like healthy, bronzy, slightly glowy. This is a shade that's so interesting. I don't have another shade like this. That's the reason why I love it, but it's also, there is something about this pigmentation. It's really pigmented, but in a way that is easy to blend and that it just looks like your skin, like your cheeks are perfected. And I love that. The next blush is this Catrice Cheek Lover Oil Infused Blush. I've been raving about this. This is a coral blush with a golden sheen. Not glittery at all. It just looks very healthy and glowy on your cheeks. And it almost looks like a cream. It just blends in so effortlessly, so easy. It's not dry at all. It's just really a beautiful, warm color that goes with so many looks. But I especially love wearing it with a bit of a warmer toned eye and a warmer toned lip. I think this is a blush that would look good on so many people. It's not too pigmented, but you can build it up and it just has such a beautiful shine. This is a product that I feel like deserves so much more hype than it's getting. I hear nobody talking about this, but the quality of this is like high-end quality. This For this quality, I would easily pay like 20, 30 euros easily. Next up, I have a blush that I completely panned. I completely used it up. And this is the replacement I have for it. So I know I love this. This is like my OG favorite blush. And that is the Max Factor Creme. It says here Pastel Compact Blush, but I know this as the Creme Puff Blush, so I don't know exactly what the name of this is, but it's like the Baked Blush from the Baked Blush line from Max Factor, and this is Seductive Pink. This is a beautiful, like, neutral, soft pink with also kind of like a lilac-y cool-toned pink glow in there, so it looks very flattering and glowy, not shimmery, once again, not shimmery. It looks very flattering and glowy. If you want a bit, almost like a lilac-y sheen on your cheeks, it looks really good if you have like a neutral to cool skin tone. Then it really brightens up the face because it has this kind of cool toned glow to it that isn't too like bluish or too cool. It just adds a really beautiful natural sheen, and there's just something about this color. It's so beautiful, and once again, it's pigmented in a really beautiful way and really easy to work with. I never have any trouble blending it out. I'm wearing it today. It doesn't look really like extremely cool toned. It just meshes with my skin very well. I really, really love this. That one is just amazing. And there was a point in time where I was just using that blush every day of the week. I was using that blush. Okay, so let's move on to some cream cheek products. I have to say, I don't really have OG favorites when it comes to cream cheeks. I've only been getting into it like the past few months. So these are newer products in my collection. I haven't used them like 50 times. I haven't used them that much. These other products I've used more, but these cream cheeks, I know I really like them, and this is my top three, and I have faith in them that they're good products, but they're a bit like, I wasn't sure if I was gonna put this category in because they're just a bit newer in my life, in my collection. I'm not that well versed in cream cheeks just yet. But I just wanted to show these to you, just in case you just know. And you just have to keep that in mind. So the first thing is this Kiko Fruit Explosion Juicy Blush. This is a liquid blush in kind of like a really warm corally shade. I feel like this is easy to blend out. It has a beautiful creamy finish, not extremely glowy, but still like a natural sheen to it. I really love this color. It's really warm, but it still has some pinkiness in there. I feel like the fact that it's kind of corally makes it really easy to wear. Even for someone with a more cool undertone, this just works really well. I really like wearing this. I just think it's an interesting shade, interesting formula. And it's not a formula that's too pigment where you just have to put a few dots and then it's already too much. You can put quite a bit and blend it out. And I feel like the fact that it's more buildable in pigment makes it easier to use. Then I have this 3-in-1 All Over Stick by Kiko as well. I'm really into Kiko products. I've tried a lot of their stuff, so there are some Kiko things in here because I just really, really love their quality, especially when it comes to their limited editions. So this one is from the Mood Boost collection. This one is the shade 04. It's kind of like a rosy pink. This is so beautiful on the cheeks. I really love how creamy this looks, and it's so easy to blend out, and it's just so easy to use, and it looks so nice and natural, and it has a beautiful color to it. I love this rosy pink shade. I love how my cheeks look when I wear this. It looks amazing. It's also really easy to kind of correct mistakes when your bronzer didn't blend out that well, or you put another cheek product down first and it didn't blend as well. Put this over top and it's gonna look great. I think when it comes to like quality, this might even be better than that liquid blush. Yeah, I think from all these three, this is the best quality, but the other ones just have a little bit more of an interesting finish and color. But this is just, if you are a beginner and you're not sure where to start and you are a bit scared if you're gonna be able to blend out cream products, try something like this first. So the last thing here is this Kiko Milano Dolce Diva Glam Cushion Highlighter. This is in the shade 02. This is a bit of a rose gold type of shade. This is a really metallic highlighter, but I use it as a blush, so that's why I put it in here. But There's also a highlighter shade and there's also a bronzy, kind of bronzy shade in this. And if you have a little bit of a deeper skin tone, you can definitely get away with this as a highlighter. This is a really beautiful, glowy cheek product. It is easy to blend. It's something that does dry down, but it does stay very glowy. So this is really like, if you like glowy cheek products, if you like almost metallic cheeks, then this is something you might like. You have enough time to blend, but it's also something where you don't have sticky cheeks. So that's what I like about this. I don't use this like all the time because it sometimes feels like it's a bit much, but I really love the effect when I wear it, and it's just a great product. And I just really love how it just dries down and it's not messy or anything. This is a bit of a Charlotte Tilbury dupe. I also got the Charlotte Tilbury Beauty Light wand, but I haven't used that enough to really put that in a favorites like this, but I know for sure that I like this one. All right, so let's move on to bullet lipsticks. First up, I have this Power Plumping Gel Lipstick in the shade 170 by Catrice. This is a sheer shiny lipstick in kind of like a peachy pink nude shade. This has some shimmers in it, which is fine. It isn't my absolute favorite, but just looking at my collection, this is definitely one of my favorites. I haven't been that much into lip products for the last maybe 3 years. So it was really hard to pick something because I feel like my lip collection consists of quite old products, older favorites, things that I used to wear. And this is just what I'm wearing a lot right now. But I feel like if I would get into it a bit more, then probably I would have different favorites. If I would really like research and see what would be perfect for me, maybe I would find something else. But if I just look at what I have, this is a favorite. I would really recommend this formula, but maybe I would recommend checking out a color that doesn't have as much shimmer as this one. Although I still think it looks nice. It is a beautiful shade on the lips, but I think if I would buy something like this again from Catrice, I'd probably just go for one without shimmer. But this is a really nice lipstick for sure. This is a favorite. But it was hard to choose these lip products because I haven't really been buying and trying lip products. And I feel like many of the things that I have in my lip basket aren't really like favorites. So this one is a favorite. This one, even if I would buy other things, would be into other things, I think I would be still very much in love with this lipstick. This is a La Plage lipstick by MAC. No longer available. I'm really sorry about it. Maybe they will bring it back at some point because MAC is known to sometimes bring back certain shades, but this was from their like bronzy collection last year, their summer collection. This is a really beautiful cool-toned bronze, but it's like sheer and shiny. It has really, really subtle shimmer in it. It just makes it look really like flattering and shiny. It's not like, it's not too much, it's not too metallic, it's not too gritty. There is just something about this shade that really, really works on me. Because it's sheer, it looks so flattering and kind of bronzy, but not in a weird way. I love wearing this lipstick, and I wish they had this in the line that they always have. This is a beautiful, beautiful lipstick. They did it just right, because often these types of lipsticks are just a little bit too metallic, a little bit too cool toned, a little bit too warm toned, a little bit weird, but this is the right balance of everything. Then lastly, I have the Catrice Ultra High Shine Lipstick in Make It Nuder. And this is also a sheer shiny lipstick. This is just what I'm into right now. And this is a cool toned nude sheer lipstick that looks really creamy, really flattering on the lips. Also makes me look kind of bronzy. There's something about this undertone that makes me look kind of bronzed. I think it's because it has this nice coolness in it that works well when it's a bit sheer. This is kind of similar in a way to that A La Plage lipstick, but this doesn't have that kind of almost metallic-y shine to it. Yeah, I feel like the A La Plage lipstick is a little bit deeper and it has a metallic shine, but if you want something that's a similar vibe that's cheaper and that's also available, then I would go with this Make It Nuder shade. I think the fact that I have two lipsticks here that are very similar shows how much I love a cool toned nude sheer shiny lipstick. It's my fave. So I have three liquid lipstick kind of products here and I have one lip gloss. I don't have enough favorite lip glosses. I don't even have enough lip glosses really to make a top three, but I did want to share with you the one lip gloss that's my favorite. But first I'm going to show you the liquid lipsticks kind of products, and then I'm going to show you that gloss just on its own in its kind of own category. I think it deserves a place in this video. So the first liquid lipstick that I love is this Creamy Lip Stain by Onus Eye. This is the shade Little Jasmine, and this is a beautiful warm nude. It has enough pigment to it, but in a way that it still looks kind of sheer and shiny. It is a really dimensional kind of lip color. It's really comfortable on the lips. It's really easy to wear. It's a really beautiful shade. It also has a beautiful, beautiful scent to it. There is something about this scent that just makes me... it makes me want to wear this lipstick. It takes me back to my youth. It smells like candy that I used to eat, or some kind of ice cream that I used to eat. Something really nice and sweet. That's what this smells like. I love it. And I just think this is something else. There's something about this shiny liquid lip that's different from other shiny products that I use. I can't really put my finger on it. I can't really explain, but it's like opaque and pigmented, but also kind of sheer at the same time. It's not that sheer, but it's almost like multi-layered. It almost looks like you have multiple layers on your lips. There's something about this. I just really, really love it. Then next up, one of my favorite liquid lip formulas that I feel like nobody's talking about, that I think deserves more hype, is the Sephora Cream Lip Stain Formula. Now, I just picked a shade, but it could have been a different shade on a different day. If I was in a different mood, it could have been a different shade. But I just wanted to show you one of my faves from this line. This is a shade 41. This is a beautiful, dark, rosy shade. It's kind of vampy, but it's also kind of nude. It has a really interesting undertone. This formula, to me, is not drying at all. And almost all other liquid lipsticks that I've tried were drying to me. Way too drying. I feel like this is really comfortable to wear. It's also easy to just put a little bit of lip balm underneath. Sometimes with some liquid lipsticks, that doesn't really work. But you can easily wear lip balm underneath these. So I still sometimes wear them in like fall and winter when my lips are a little bit more dry. But I love the pigmentation of these. They are not too expensive. There are so many shades, so many beautiful colors. But I think the most important thing here is that it's a really opaque matte liquid lipstick that isn't too dry. And this is really what I love about these. Another shade that I also really, really love is shade 13. That's a beautiful rosy nude that I used to wear a lot. Like a few years ago, those types of shades, those rosy nudes were all I wore. So that is also one that I would definitely recommend. That's also really a favorite. Then next up, I have this NABLA Dreamy Creamy Liquid Lipstick in the shade Eve. And I really think this is a beautiful, comfortable formula. It has a little bit of a cooling sensation to it. It's really pigmented, it's really creamy, but it doesn't go everywhere. I don't love the dark shade that I have as much as the nude shades that I have. I think this formula works really well in the nude shades. And this is kind of like a peachy pink. It's not too deep. It works with a lot of makeup looks. And it just looked really like flattering and creamy on the lips. It's definitely not as shiny as the Alva Cream Lip Stains. Those are more almost glossy looking. This is more of a creamy look. And I really, really love wearing this, especially when my lips are dry. This is so good. This is definitely almost like a thick lip gloss. Not exactly, but it's not something that's not gonna transfer. It's not something that's gonna wear forever, but it has enough pigment to wear for a while. I just really love wearing lipsticks that aren't super, super matte and that aren't drying. Now, the lip product, the lip gloss that I wanted to put in this video, that's like the only lip gloss, if I think about a favorite lip gloss that I think about, is this Nawla Stardust Radio lip gloss. This is from the Shine Theory line. This is very comfortable. It has a nice fruity, kind of fruit-like scent to it. And it's a really beautiful shade. It's kind of like a see-through warm red. And then it has a golden shine to it. The glitter in here, the shimmer in here is not gritty at all. It's really comfortable. I love, love, love wearing this one so much. I haven't really tried any of their other shades. I don't know if any one of them could beat this one, could make me happier or as happy as I am with this shade, because this shade is just so good. All right, so we have arrived at eyeshadow palettes. And I was a bit unsure what eyeshadow palettes to put in here. I find it difficult to choose. I really love eyeshadow palettes. I have so many favorite eyeshadow palettes. And my eyeshadow tastes are changing a bit. And they're changing a bit compared to last year. But they're also once again changing a bit in comparison to a few months ago. I feel like my tastes in eyeshadow are constantly evolving. And I just found it a bit hard to do this. So I have some honorable mentions. So the first palette that I want to mention is the Glamlight Ice Cream Dream eyeshadow palette. I was kind of debating whether I should put this one in, but in the end, this is a palette that gives me a lot of options, beautiful shimmers, beautiful mattes, and that I've used a lot of. I've used this one a lot. I love this palette. Some of these shimmers have such a beautiful dimension and texture to them, while still being very like pigmented and opaque. Sometimes shimmers have more of a sheer base. Definitely nowadays, we have all these topper shades, which is nice, but I don't always want to go for something like that, and that's why I go into this palette a lot. Love this palette. I don't even do like a crazy amount of pastel looks with this. I go into these neutrals so much, and I love the neutral looks I do with this. Next up, I put the Nawla Dreamy eyeshadow palette. I love this palette so much. This color story represents me. I love a mix of neutrals and colors. I love cool tones with a pop of like rosiness or pink in there. That's something I can really appreciate. This is a palette with shimmers that are really creamy, but not extremely textured or extremely dimensional. No duochromes really. But we have this kind of like peach to gold, but these shimmers are more on the basic side, but they have this beautiful shiny pigmentation that I personally love. And I just am really inspired when I look at this palette. I love creating looks with it. Even though it looks kind of basic, it just keeps inspiring me, and I love this palette so, so much. Then last up, the palette that I couldn't not put in this, although it's not the palette that I use the absolute most, it's the Kaleidos and Angelica Nyquist Club Nebula palette. This is like a treasure in my collection. This is a palette that I treasure. I don't use it every day. I don't use it all the time. It's pretty colorful, and I go for more neutral looks nowadays a bit more. But still, I can say that this is a favorite, just because of the fact that it is so beautifully done. I love the theme, but I also love Angelica. I just think she's a great creator. I love watching your videos. This is really a colorful palette that inspires me and that has such great quality. This is definitely my favorite colorful palette. I love this one. It's just one that I don't reach for every day, but that doesn't make it less of a favorite for me. Now let's talk about two honorable mentions. I was kind of debating if I would put the Norns eyeshadow palette in or if I would put the Glamlight eyeshadow palette in. And this probably would have been the one that I would have picked if I were more into color right now. Because the thing that I love about this is these colorful shimmers on the bottom row. These shimmers are so dimensional, so creamy and kind of thick and pigmented, and they really amp up a look. And I love those shimmers, but they are not my everyday kind of colors right now. So it's kind of like my mood right now. This almost got into the top three. It was really, really close. I still wanted to show you because I just can't not mention this in this video. And maybe in a few months I would put this in looking back. This is an amazing palette, but it does give you some more like colorful options, and the things that I love in here are the colorful options, so that's why it didn't get in this time. Like, it isn't like my top three right now. Then the palette that used to be my favorite palette for such a long time, this was my favorite palette. But my tastes are changing a bit. I've added some new palettes to my collection, but I still wanted to mention it. That's the ColourPop Strawberry Shake eyeshadow palette. I used to do peachy pink and peachy eye looks all the time. I used to use this all the time. I used to do those kinds of looks like all throughout summer. Now I'm moving away from that a little bit, but this is a palette that was a favorite of mine that was in my top three for such a long time, so I still wanted to show you. This has a beautiful shimmer formula, beautiful matte formula, beautiful range of shades. You can go more peachy, more pinky, more bright, more toned down. I really love the options of mattes over here that can deepen up looks. I still really love the palette, and I just wanted to mention that one here as well. So that's gonna be everything for my top three in every category that I thought mattered. Let me know in the comments what you would pick for these categories. Let me know if you tried any of these products. Do you agree with me? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe. And then I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.